Welcome back to the OpenVINO channel. Our application is a full pipeline. We're streaming the video, decoding it, because we usually get it compressed from the camera RTSP feed or file, doing some format conversion and image processing, and then inference, maybe post-processing the result, or encoding the result in video for display, storage, or upstream. Maybe we even have many video streams running through the same pipeline. This is, of course, a very simple kind of application, and a real application could have loops, feedbacks across video streams or video frames. If we have a heterogeneous system with a CPU, integrated GPU, and accelerators like Movidio's VPU or FPGA, theoretically, each of these pipe stages could run on a different device. We could run the decode on the GPU, the pre-processing on the CPU, and the inference on the Movidio's VPU, and so on. But how can I tell if this workload can really work on my system without actually coding it? How can one predict what will be the expected frame per seconds or how many video streams I can really process in parallel? For the inference part, we have talked about the benchmark utility. You can use it to estimate the performance of your model on a specific system. Please refer to video 32. But I want to build this full pipeline quickly so I can run it with different combination of pipe stages running on CPU or GPU or others, and potentially how can I run this pipeline on multiple systems to choose the right one for me. Now we can build and simulate such a pipeline with GStreamer. GStreamer is a framework for creating streaming video application. It's free, open source, and widely used. Please find all the documentations and tutorials on this link. In this video, I'll try to explain the concept, talk about installation, and show a one simple demo. On the next video, we'll talk about multiple streams and other samples. GStreamer can take elements, pipeline them to each other, and construct a full workload. GStreamer element could be, for example, open a file for video reading, decode the video, convert the format, and so on. We have basically added analytic elements that use OpenVINO to the pool of elements. So now you can use inference operations in such pipelines. If we go to the GitHub page, you can see the description of the new elements. They all start with GVA for GStreamer Video Analytics, and they can do inference, detection, classification, and more. A typical workload that we can construct may look like this. This is really one line that describes the full pipeline. The source of the pipeline is a video file. The exclamation marks indicate a new pipe stage. And the next stage is to decode the video. And then convert the format so it will match the inference input format. And now we're running inference. The model is face detection, and we can add here all the required parameters. And now we want to draw the detection results on the original image. And we display it to the screen. So you see how simple it is to describe and build a real video analytics pipeline. Now, let's do it together. All the instructions are in the GitHub. Let's take a look at the page. You can see here the hardware and software prerequisites. Let's go to the Get Started guide. Here, just follow the instructions to get the data, the deep learning models, and the repository. You'll need to add your input video file, place them under GVA/data/videos. Under data/models, you can find all the models. And now for the installation, you can install everything on your local machine, or you can run it in Docker, which could be even more convenient. Once everything is installed, let's just run one sample. I'll make sure OpenVINO is initialized, and there are some environment parameters to make sure are set. Let's take a look at one simple sample, face detection and classification. This is the input video file. These are the deep learning models to use. The device is CPU. You can make it any device you like. And here is a GStreamer command line. We read the video file, we decode it, convert the format, and now detection run on the CPU. And now take the result of the detection and perform classification and another classification. And now present the result. GVA watermark is doing this. Assuming I do not know what it does, I go back to the web page. I look at the data flow, description of the new elements, and you can see that this element knows how to present the detection or classification results on the original image. And it's running. So basically, we saw how to install and run a sample. The sample is a full application with three different models for detection and classification. And you can build it in one line. Now, you can build applications using it or benchmark the performance on any target machine in a Docker. This is a powerful tool for creating pipelines. Use it. Next video, we'll see more examples and more options. See you there. Thank you.